I see a ton of garbage articles posted on the internet every single day. It is a plague that's never gonna go away, and I'm so sick of seeing male gamers being attacked or being belittled on the internet due to the color of their skin or sexual preferences. And here we are again, seeing game journalists doing just that. And I'd like to start off this video with saying a quote I say a lot: inclusivity by exclusivity never works, and it never will. So this is a gamesindustry.biz article that I'm using an archive of because I definitely didn't want to give them my click. If you're still marketing to white cis males, you're alienating more than half of your players. Assassin's Creed Sisterhood co-founder on the importance of putting defined female characters in the spotlight. Women don't sell video games. This is the quote that they start this article out with. That's one of the attitudes allegedly expressed by Ubisoft's marketing department and management on 2018's Assassin's Creed Odyssey, mandating the game needed a playable male as an alternative to Cassandra. I say this all of the time, and I'm going to say it again. The more options for players, the better. It says, though, but Culprit Verdi, I hope that I'm saying her name right, founder of the fan movement Assassin's Creed Sisterhood, is urging games firms to move beyond this outdated perception, and she believes the new releases, or the way new releases are promoted, is crucial. It's a really backwards way of thinking, she says. When you're marketing your game to men, you're ultimately ostracizing 50% of your player base. There's a misconception that women just play cutesy games like Stardew Valley, The Sims, Animal Crossing. That just needs to go away. The player base has changed. She adds, it's like this vicious circle we really need to break. And there have been games that have broken this circle, like Horizon Zero Dawn, the Tomb Raider series, The Last of Us with Ellie and Abby front and center. The problem is there's just a general lack of marketing campaigns that focus on women, and the marketing campaigns that focus on men tend to do really well because they've got the budget and support behind them. Now let's look at the first paragraph here. You're ultimately ostracizing 50% of your player base. Now I could literally make the argument here that by removing a male playable character to make room for a female character, Ubisoft or any company would be ostracizing the other 50% of their player base. Now I'm not saying that I don't want more female leads in games because I love seeing strong females in games, but this argument is flawed and extremely weak to make. It's just not true. Men will gladly play a female lead, and females will gladly play a male lead as long as the story is good and the character is good. So where's this argument even coming from? What polls or focus groups are they pointing to that proves what they're saying? Show me the evidence. It goes both ways here. Unless they have some new statistic to prove otherwise, they're actually wrong about who makes up the gaming market, because the majority of people who play what I'll call hardcore games like Assassin's Creed and excluding mobile games are actually male. Look, I play Apex Legends, Call of Duty, League of Legends, and you're going to sit here and tell me that half of the people I'm playing against are female? It's just not true, and I seriously doubt the validity of anything that they're saying here that says 50% of Assassin's Creed players are female as well, and this article is about diversity in Assassin's Creed. I definitely think there's a lot of females who play these games, don't get me wrong, but in general, we know that females lean towards different genres than men, like mobile games, for instance. There are a lot of females that play mobile games. So let's use science to get our statistics, and I don't see any in this article at all whatsoever. But let's move on to the next portion where they talk about things like Horizon Zero Dawn, Tomb Raider, Last of Us. The problem is that there's just a general lack of marketing campaigns that focus on women. Games like Horizon Zero Dawn and Tomb Raider and The Last of Us Part 2 had plenty of money behind them and plenty of marketing behind them. Those games were all successes. I mean, even The Last of Us Part 2 did have a lot of backlash and controversy behind it, but it still sold relatively well. So why would you be using those examples? She's creating a false narrative that women are oppressed in video games and it doesn't exist. It just doesn't at all, whatsoever. Is she trying to compare the fact that there's more lead male characters in video games than females to something akin to women's suffrage? This is a ridiculous argument. Not to mention, even though there are male lead characters, there's still plenty of female lead characters or female options in games. But continuing on with the article, it talks about the beginning of Assassin's Creed Sisterhood and how back in July, amid the slew of accusations concerning abuse, harassment, and toxic attitudes at Ubisoft, including the notion that female protagonists don't sell video games. They talk about that history a little bit and the beginning of their Discord server and their Twitter. There's definitely been a lot of rumors surrounding Ubisoft and how they supposedly foster a toxic culture within the company, which obviously, if it's true, is absolutely disgusting. But first of all of these reports only ever came from anonymous sources who talked to Jason freaking Schreier at Bloomberg. And there were only big accusations made towards the chief creative officer who actually left, and since then there's really been no news about any problems at the company, so maybe he was the problem, and now that he's gone there aren't as many problems, or maybe they've just gotten the offices under control. Maybe they're still very bad, but unless someone speaks up, it's all just speculation at this point, and we don't really ever know if all of those accusations were true, because they were only from a couple of anonymous sources who talked to Jason freaking Schreier. But continuing on with the article, let's scroll down a little bit because this is a very long article and a lot of it is just nonsense. She continues on with saying, "I've always wanted to see an Assassin's Creed game where the woman is the lead, not a diminished or supporting role. Seeing everything that happened, I decided to speak up and do something about it. To say that this needs to change, because if no one does that, nothing will change." And I kind of agree with her. If you don't speak up about issues you're passionate about, nothing is going to change. But she is literally saying, she wants women as leads, not a diminished or supporting role. Supporting female roles in games can be just as important as main characters. They can help the story progress. They can be why the story is the story. There are plenty of females that are, you know, supporting roles in games, like Triss or Yennefer in The Witcher, that are extremely imperative to the story that they're trying to tell. Just because a character's in a supporting role doesn't mean they're diminished. But let's start here. It says there's a systemic issue at play here too. The lack of female protagonists. While an annual analysis shows this is improving, defined female characters are still a minority when it comes to games protagonists. If there aren't any women to include in the marketing, how can the way games are promoted improve? That phrase, defined female character, is also important. While many games give players the option of playing as either a man or woman, as soon as the choice is presented, it diminishes the woman to just that. An option. They take this stance that just because a female is an option, that instantly diminishes their worth, and that is not true. And that's not how a lot of gamers think either. I don't think companies go, "Let's write our lead as a male because screw women." They write them as men because their story flows better, or their story was originally supposed to revolve around a male. Having an option to play as a female character is much better than not having an option to at all. And these people will complain no matter what if the option exists. If the option doesn't exist, you're never going to win with these people. They are always going to try to ruin your company over something. If it's not one thing, they will find something else to attack you for. That's why I don't understand why developers are so worried about pleasing them. Focus on the people who really buy your games and who really care about your games. It says, "For me, it shows that you're not prepared to commit to a female character," says the founder of Assassin's Creed Sisterhood. "I think that companies rely on the male version to be their backup for men who don't want to play as women, and that's unfortunate because then the narrative is the same. These people are never happy. We've fought for more options in games, and as a female, I like to see the fact that I can play a game as a female or a male. For me, I'd rather see just a good story, and if that good story can be played as a male or a female, I'm all for it. Give me those options, as many options as possible." And I think that a lot of people agree with that. But men don't just not play a game because a female is a protagonist. It's like Tomb Raider. There are plenty of men out there who freaking love Tomb Raider. Let's look at The Last of Us. The Last of Us Part 2 was a very iffy game, in my opinion, but plenty of people like that. And even The Last of Us Part 1, a lot of people really loved. And, you know, Ellie was a main character in that too. It's just a ridiculous argument that they make that the narrative is the same unless they go all female. The more options, the better. And let's be happy that they've given us those options at all. It says, "Sometimes you're playing these games and the character will say something that seems really weird if you're playing as a certain gender. It doesn't work and sometimes it can break the narrative. It's a better approach to focus on one and really concentrate on their character development, their story, and make sure their representation is authentic and sensitive. Unless it's a male, because that's what they're rallying against. Less males in games." So they're saying, it's better if you focus on one gender, but only the specific gender that we want, because we want diversity and inclusivity by excluding a certain gender. It's absolutely ridiculous, the things that they say here. The thing is that this whole article is supposed to push the point that diversity in games and options are good for players. Then they say things like, They don't want those options for players that might want to play as one specific gender. They want all females or absolutely nothing. They're literally saying only making a female as an option diminishes the woman, which clearly means that they want more games to be only female leads. Screw the men, apparently. And that means less diversity and less options. They provide no evidence to their arguments at all whatsoever, which could be taken apart very easily. I just hate seeing clickbait BS posted like this, and that's why it's important for me to call it out when I see it. Inclusivity by exclusivity never works, and it never will, but let everyone know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed this video and found it important and informative, please make sure to give it a like, share it, and subscribe to the channel. And of course, if you didn't, make sure to give it a dislike. I appreciate your support either way, but I will talk to you all again in the next video, really soon.